stand in the water and I'll start to rest there upon the banks of my bed.
Thank you.
Before the importance of this fact of life, we can tell at this point, so it's best to wait for us to rest back to the deity, the person, and the devil's just going to the top of the world. So important voice, even after that, I don't know if you want that or not, but as you know, some of us who are represent the mystical gift of the rest of the wisdom. And so, the two guys, we have the Congress that we said that, so at this point, weekend these people do. And very rarely is it rewarded to sit down and enjoy God's solutions to do it right now. It is much easier, especially with social media. If I can put my whole platform in 140 characters, I would. Didn't used to do that. It used to have to actually walk through some pretty serious hurdles and actually see them differently, so you understand how complicated and difficult it could be. It's never really a black and white issue or anything, and it's just a matter of what works out right. And the principles are important, but solutions are not. So I think America's going to have to start rewarding people who go there to find solutions. And here is, you may not get everything you want. And if anyone's carried in the crowd, you know that's pretty good stuff. So I think you're not going to get anything. So I think that we've got to get back in this race and get legislators, talk about celebrities, and legislators. I love the legislative process. I love the work that we try to make sure that things can be right, the budget can be right, that my part of the stuff can be right, to kill people who do the work that they're doing, that didn't conflict with my principles. You can do it. I think that's the definition of legislation. That's almost what my purpose is. I think that's what I'm saying. So if there's fighting in the competition, go and fight that fight. You want to be there, and you want to advocate for that. And over time, it'll come back. This is, we're pretty young country, we've seen this before. I think that gets back to the person who will participate in what is really important institution for our citizens. And if we continually to dismiss it, they continue to get power to judge with the wall of the emotions. And maybe your party, you like what you see, you know, but what they will show you somebody who is better. And they're going to be better. I don't care what party you are. And that's why, for so many years, we push back as what is the legitimate oversight body for making sure no matter who the president is, there's tension, but it doesn't have to be combined. It's all combined. Everything. Which is why the State Department doesn't do so much. And I find that when I first went through my process of reinstituting the budget, if you're in an intelligence agency, you have the answer to that. You have much money and where you spend it. Do you really want somebody knocking on your door saying, where's that money? Of course, you got to rescue the region. But what they found out was, make us very clear that nothing was part of the problem. He said, I supported something that was classified. I wasn't going to put my, if the lights got turned on, I wasn't going to put my back and say, well, I lied, and so I'm not going to. Right? And that happens a lot this time. And so I just made it very clear that if we're working on this together, I believe it would, of course, with the law, with all the checks that we would go through. And what we found is I built a relationship with them because I wasn't tough on them. I think that's a part of the way for us to be with each other in these restaurants. They were behind closed doors, but they knew I was there as well. And I think that is the true life of the old nation where our legislature is versus this new one that I can get 5,000 rights and insult them to me. I can bring great things. That we have to be speaking. That does. Thank you. still brutality. And so then we need to set slaves so we can walk across the world and reach the street. Where I've already told the other things in Christians. That species of presence is where they should be. Make this the brutality. We haven't really seen that being done. We saw a little bit of that with the Taliban. The Taliban set that criteria. They really did better with the violence and brutality. Not to this off the chart. Even though a lot of the other sophisticated, especially with social media, at least some of them, if you see some good Taliban videos, compared to what the short productions of ISIS is producing, that would be worse. It's something filmed in the garage versus CBS News, but it's very different than the language is what leads to the realm of the CBS. This use of language is what you don't see any of that in these videos. So if somebody is sitting in the likely Western Roman roads, helping them through this process, and it is exceptional, that to me is the biggest difference. And they're willing to go for it. That's a fundamental change. What's interesting about that is that how we put it in and how often debated in one of the papers that came out of the UBI World Times, you could see that this was a general debate between two leaders in the organization. But so how we talk about needing to find a place to hold for in the state of California. And UBL often told them that they don't really take up too much time, too much resource. So this tension of holding ground was around a white body who places allegiance to the dead body, and there's more people in the trap, and then there might be some argument about this. An argument was, I'm ready to hold ground, I have Western passport holders, I want to hold ground and take the fight to the United States. So Holly wasn't ready to do that, which is quite possible. So that's what's changed. And now you can see they are willing to fight and hold ground in governance. But their government style is as brutal as what you can read about in this man on the front of the table. And it's that what I think is different about that the folks who don't We can talk about what we need domestically and all these kind of targets that are open and exposed. It is a huge challenge to find other organizations that can help open law enforcement. You have to try to integrate with all investigative and intelligence based investigations. And what you want to do is get into something and interdict it early on in the process, really difficult. We're going to talk about that for 10 years if we don't be able to find the crisis. The attack was likely came from America, so they need to right across the border, and how they believe that they carry their own weapons, so they have to assemble weapons, they didn't have to assemble violence in Turkey itself. When you do that, that ratchets up their security, and it ratchets up how difficult it makes it. There is no other party that's going to make a mistake that you can get into to find out about that weapons. So there's no self-control. That's very dangerous, very difficult. High degree of operational security is in fact what needs to be in place. It's a very political structure for the purpose of that resource. And so when you look at that, you need to come to one conclusion pretty quickly. The longer we let them rule in South Korea, in Eastern Syria, run their headquarters that are going to survive them, the more we are going to be able to find Paris and Turkey and the United States. When you have the CIA director who basically contradicted the President of the United States, said that not only are they strong, but they have the capability to strike the United States, followed up by the Director of National Intelligence like that in the last month, that tells you something is wrong. And they're getting stronger than they ever were to reach out to us in a bad way. If we don't deal with that problem, as hard as it's going to be and as ugly as it's going to be, forget what we actually got back to the very I thought that was the time that I had to help with the transition to myself. I think the most military context, because I think the most defined, and that created this huge gap where everybody leaves. The government is the technocrats, the fact that we know it's not a job. That would have been horrific. So early on, I think West was sort of very productive role in giving us out a place to go, how to transition, what would look like a transition. Now, once that kind of idea about the relationship, and that, so you have to continue. You start moving into Raqqa with an incredible Turkish Arab force, supported by the United States, European allies. Really, that would be the biggest issue. So I do think that there could be this thing. Very slow in the party, they're just getting going on the DoD within the last 6 months, so that they're going to use offensive cyber capabilities to go for some of these places. Communication nodes, it's been okay, it hasn't been like the perception. I don't think that's been pretty good. But kind of messaging, we're still in any nation, I think press release. We just come back up to that's where you need to find something. And you need to find something to help us through what the appropriate messaging means to try to make sure we can interdict at least the messaging that goes down to the team. We were looking for a reason to use the relationship. And you're going to get a pretty good relationship and you work well. I certainly have a very great agency in the United States, the referee, where it wasn't working, certainly. And sometimes that's even worse than having federal agencies. And so the next culture coming up, I think, is more bringing to cooperation and understanding the values of the old institution or the state part. Those are still there, as they believe. I always think they there's going to be no law passed or the regulations we have told them that they're going to get it off, they're working in the box. Now it's going to be up to the leadership and personality of the I'm you do it, you're going to get tired. How do you do it? I've never walked into this issue. And the thing is really good. The Fourth Amendment. It doesn't say you can't get some of the papers. It says you're going to get some of the papers. You have to go through this process. And you have to go to your independent judiciary with a pretty high legal standard to get them. That was the protection of the Fourth Amendment. I think reinterpretation that I find the Bible says you can't have a good amendment. It's not what they say. They say if you want it, yes, you do. And as a law enforcement guy, I took that very seriously. These are the things, these are the legal standards you need to meet in order to get some person. So I never believe there's a trade-off. There's just a high standard you have to meet, but we have to do it to meet that standard. That's right. You will make it so impossible that you can't. Or remove any legal standard that it's to use. That's the argument. We all have it on the list. There is no debate, any congressional debate or meaningful meeting trying to tell me what, how do you handle it? How do you handle it? Are the risks integrated? The answer to the question is, if it's a job, I feel like it's a drunken monkey in the room. That's how you get in the room. So, Rogers is So, I'm just trying to. But we don't, and they look like still don't work together with the strategy. And so, criminal profile works, meaning that you have to hit several metrics. It might be race, maybe it's color, but it can't be the only thing. It's behavior, it's location. If someone has gone back and forth for a certain time in Pakistan, in the tribal areas, where we know we have a high percentage of problem, and we know that this person is related to a Pakistani person from this particular it would be okay to say, okay, they put several, not that some Pakistani into Pakistan. That would be but they, this particular village and this particular town associated with this particular people, then yes, race should be a part of it, or their ethnic background should be a part of it, the Pakistani example. So, this notion that we can just put everything on this category doesn't disservice to all the other things. And it's wrong. It's wrong. And it's horribly inefficient. So what we have to do is understand the business. So maybe today it's so people get so great and sensitive about it. There's a huge difference between a criminal profile and a racial profile. And we should all be in unity by using profile. It's done by the criminal profiles do work. And it could have race as a part of the question. You can do a write-down job at one time, perhaps. We are looking at you too. But there's simply no good reason to be in this place, such as these individuals who are figuring out what to do. Yeah, I was. I never quite got there. I was burning with the classified view of the world. Sometimes I got in touch with people try to explain. Because people would use this strip number as a 5-5 range, they got all 5. But this is not exactly how it works. It would happen as an applies and use it, and the judge would kick it back, or the clerk, and then the clerk would kick it back and say, well, the judge members don't even bother, don't waste anybody's time. So they kick it back, they go back. So it's basically that everyone was accepted. They probably not a very good understanding. Judges, talk to the judges. I don't agree with them. I think there's no play stuff with it, climb into with all of the folks in it. And they must have something. But you know, with the really only process in the information field to contain it, we felt very highly disabled. The collection with the metadata from backstory down the process and people really like that information to be given to me. It's not as easy to get to the details that sort of it was really just a little bit from the experience of the value and the result of the most awesome person. But other than that, I think those processes for circumstances. Came down with a rule here, and I think that I agree with that. So we're going to have to have a policy discussion. What do we want? What would we expect our law enforcement to do in the case? Clearly, that applies to the legal standard where most reasonable Americans are saying, okay, we're caught in shooting people. They're driven the operation, that's their phone, I'm the person, it's just from everything. Clearly, we can speak it. I even have to break that. That was a
and we have to figure this out. I think that there's a where the key is held by just tail bumper or just you can bifurcate the technology, you can keep it separate, just like it takes two people with two separate keys to talk to people in front. We can create the technology to do this. They already have something similar that they operate on. It's working. They market to you. And when you use their phone, somebody's getting all the information, but this happens to be a big corporation. So the question is, can you find something that would meet this really high legal test and not endanger what the government would be doing for us? I argue it can be done. We're not quite there yet. We're going to take a look. If you want to protect Apple's ability to sell phones in Europe and the Middle East, that would be a disaster for allow our great American company. It's an ability to have an overseas market that, that's not great for the country. One is they require you to provide the service to your partner or yourself. That's a clue for the reason why you're not getting it wrong. And secondly, what they did with Apple is they Apple agreed to store the data every time you source a user over in time. So my argument is they've already seeded this to get into the market. That's why I think we're going to have that solution. I don't think it's fair anymore. If they think that phone is the same kind of protection that they have in the States, then thank you. turn to the Father. But this is what we've done. Remember, we've been poor. The rest of us turned off and we've been in the electric. But this is it. Cover it up. This is it. And you take a project to find it. We're pulling a weird thing. It works against us, it works for the rest of us, it works for the church. Because we didn't even realize that this is going to be for a fellow person to cover. Which made no sense to us. And now we want everyone to serve a fellow person to cover. It's up to 85% of the people. You want that to be in real time. You're seeing it, you're seeing it. So the government decides. That would be highly productive, that would be illegal. But to make sure that we get some threat protection to 85% of the population, including electric bills and banks, your grocery store, your Whole Foods, your favorite Starbucks. I mean, all of those things are being tracked. The fact that they can get uplinks and downlinks and satellites, and they can get satellites out of there. And they make it to the world, that's what it is. I'll tell you this, like 45 million of people who have the Starbucks. Imagine 45 million people who have the Starbucks. We've got about 45,000 Starbucks people just kind of thing. But huge amount of chance. And so we have this huge problem coming at us, and we really have not gotten out of this hangover about what they think this kind of thought needs to do. Tell you the ways we got behind the political narrative, we didn't explain it well, and now we're fighting this fight, which, as I said, the Russians are trying to use the right. Hey, what? We still can't agree with the short that the Trumps are going to get out of this. That's the nastiest source that you have ever made. We base all of our technology that's delivered for free. And that's why no one in the world can compete with Twitter, no one in that field. The Chinese realized that they knew that they were going to have a strategic adversarial role, because that kind of was what they had in the world, and that was the same thing. So since then, we've been able to work for the security. Satellites that go up for the sole purpose of being able to take out the two-satellite architecture, all of that exists. So now think about it, when you bring up a list, and as you know, weight is so it's really expensive. The rocket itself is more expensive than the engine. So now we have to take off really important pieces of technology for our great quality source to put something that allows us to protect itself from space. So we already have a cost increase and a diminished value in what electronic suit package we can produce. That's fine. And so we haven't really quite dealt with it. And we haven't dealt with this space. This is a satellite architecture. We don't have a great robust way of placing it very quickly. And so I don't think that policy is very good. Great color display about how much does that satellite cost? When do we want to replace the satellite that's been around for 20 years? Is it 2% to so we can get people to? We have got that nobody's talking about coordinated military satellite intelligence strategy. I would like to think so, but I don't think they're developing military. In any nation, they're getting these military capabilities. I think you should try. And by the way, space debris is a great part of the missile stack. They said they should not help you out with space debris. They should not work with space debris. I was thinking about being a small little piece and rip a hole in the
sack.
Well, let's talk about it. It's not as a really important thing about projects. With that project on space, and even the possibility of a space-based missile deterrent system, we're all kind of really interested in opportunities to do it at a rate that's affordable and technologically. And so, to me, I would continue to push for that while you're asking for negotiation. I always believe you have to have a plan. If you're going to be able to get that to agree, you have to say you're going to start. But if you're not going to agree, we'll just build something that works even better. Everything that keeps it going. I would do every air flight that the U.S. government engaged in my country. That was by my personal policy relationship. So because it would be a front on the policy and the reality, then I took it and I could actually report it every single recommendation. That was my opinion. So I had a little bit of a different view. So we get hung up a little bit on the fact that why we differentiate what the weapon system is. We're going to change holistically our policy around how we target people. And that's the significantly different than my argument would be really, then maybe we don't even be some special forces and so I look at it with the way that they highly group of individuals who have a really long set of checklists, protocols, and high oversight. We have shown that the committee would be quarterly meetings, So what we saw happen, some of the other military functions, these people have been for 10 years, 8 years, 1 year. They've been doing this for 5 years. The military has a few of their personal problems. I just did not know how far we were going to do this. A higher percentage of people in the past is under the team. And really, you're asking somebody to keep this. We're right behind. The intelligence and use of the military side would be different than to take care of human beings that they were talking about. And this is much of it was overwhelmed. As a matter of fact, much of what the military used was the development of weapon systems and ordnance. So remember this, but I just wanted to point this because the whole goal, though, is to work. Because it was frustrating for me to use the program and say, oh my gosh, we built a weapon. Oh my gosh, they built a weapon. I saw every single video of them. And I can tell you right now, that was an absolute nightmare. Why? Because the training, the protocols, how these weapon systems were used. And when they switched over, we started having problems. We ended up killing. I'm just telling you the protocols, the experience. We say that we have a trade-off here to have a buffer. I just thought that the goal was to disrupt people and try to be the most effective, the most disruptive event to our planet. But we didn't teach them. It was weak. There was a tempo. You do not ever want to be promoted to the position. You lasted about 2 weeks. Right? That's the operation. Yes, sir. You get 3 good weeks. You don't get this. And here's your pension. Paid for by all of us. And I don't believe in this, but we're not serious for us. And that tempo didn't allow them to get finances in order, didn't allow them to get operations planned. They spent most of their time running away. Perfect. That's exactly what we run for. But we don't have to clean it up. I argue that this change, and by the way, if you read what they've done, it is really that it may penalize the democracy and the solution to the great questions. And so, I would argue that they do need some sort of law and other things because they are available to them to change the future of the country. But they do this technically, the first part is done by a civilian intelligence agency, somebody has to run across all pieces of paper, whatever, and really call it, so okay, now you know it. And then that one they go on the right, and I'll buy some of these big boxes. For what? What? Does that make a statement? I argue that they can't make a statement that's kind of done. And we risk having an entire time of certain intelligence, which if you recall, in the state that we spent, was that DOD? Was that DOD? Some big belief in DOD since, of course, it's what most people would break. Thank you.
Three quick ones. Could you, it's June's almost over. DNI, the DCI noted that the review for the unredacted release of the commission report might be coming soon. Could you give us your opinion on the 28 pages and whether or not we'll see them unredacted? And the second question is, over the past 3 months or so, MPD, DHS, specifically the Secret Service, have gone around briefing restaurant owners and club owners in the city about the likelihood of attacks and that sort of thing. What are your thoughts on the fear of something like Orlando, whatever his specific motivations were, to happen here in the area?
Yes, hello. My name's Sean Waterman. I'm a reporter with FedScoop News. I wanted to ask you a question about cybersecurity. Mm-hmm. Mr. Rogers, do you believe that there ought to be global norms. I mean, the administration has made this sort of the center of its international policy on cybersecurity, that there should be global norms that, you know, are widely adopted. And if so, how can they be enforced? I mean, how can we be sure that the other side is keeping their end of the bargain? Recent policy paper from Microsoft called for a sort of UN-type body based on the International Atomic Agency authority to attribute major cyber attacks, so that governments wouldn't have to be involved. You know, the credibility issue that perhaps the United States has with in certain quarters of the globe. What's your response to those two?
Thank you, fascinating. Alan Moore here at Stimson. Question about Libya. Mm-hmm. So we've got two or even three new Libya reports in the last week. So a couple of questions about that and Libya. What did you learn new? And what can you say about the challenges inside the Congress of doing investigations in a bipartisan way? Was this particularly bad because of the the concern about Hillary Clinton. It's not the first time that the majority and the minority, no matter who was in charge, have not cooperated on an investigation of national interest. So the two parts.
Yeah.
Okay, please tell us who you are.
Kristen Suarez, National Defense Magazine. I kind of want to get back to when you touched on space. You said mm-hmm. that our policy was lacking in that arena. What do you think we need to do to be a dominant power in space, and what do you think our biggest threat is?
Really uninteresting for a foreign power to see one satellite that can screw up that power protection.
is